get loose and produce.
All right, yo, what's up, everybody? Today I wanted to share some of our favorite plugins with you, and hopefully you find some new gems which will spice up your production game. I tried to organize all these plugins in groups. So first up, we got the EQs. You know I'm going to talk about FatFilter Pro Q, baby. This EQ is super easy to use. It has a nice user interface and it supports dynamic EQ. Another great EQ, which serves a different purpose for me, is the Isotope Nectar 3 EQ. So each one of these bands has this function called dynamic frequency. If you select it, it will actually find a peak around where your band is, and it'll follow the peak throughout playtime. I figured I'd mention this one as an honorable mention because the Voxenko Curve EQ has this option to match EQ. So what you do is you'd load up a sample like track, or maybe your old mixdown or something that you want to kind of gather inspiration from. And then you would record your current track in there and then you'd match them. What it would do is it would create peaks to kind of balance the two tracks together. So you kind of get a similar sound to the other track. It's hard to explain, but you can find another YouTube video about it. Up next, compressors. Obviously the FatFilter Pro C is solid just for the same reasons as the Pro Q, because it's got such a user-friendly interface, making it very easy to use. But I also love using old compressors by Waves, like the C1. I don't know, I just like the sound of this compressor a lot. Same with the H compressor from Waves. I'm not gonna go into too much detail as to which compressors I prefer for what and why, because there's way better tutorials online from way smarter people than me that I can explain way better than I can. I really like the Frontier compressor because of its soft clip function. Those of you who are on Ableton, you guys have this built in with Ableton, but I haven't been able to find a good soft clipper on FL. Maybe I'm just stupid, but I really like the way this one sounds. All right, up next is a group I called Stereo Imaging. It was the best way I could generalize these plugins. So first up is the Sonalexis Stereo Tools. I use this plugin in every project. First of all, it shows the space of your sound and it lets you control the space with these knobs, and it's just a really great plugin to just see how things look. Of course, this Mexoscope has to be up there because this actually shows you the waveform of your playing track. You'd have this on your master channel. For instance, if you have headphones that don't replicate low end that well, you can play your bass and your kick and then it will play back here and you can see it digitally how loud they are, because sometimes you can't rely on your speakers or headphones. Let's move on to the distortion group. I thought I'd mention the Decapitator first, even though it's a saturator more than a distortion plugin, which is kind of the same thing. And I use this on like every bass and every, and a lot of drums even, and vocals. Honestly, I use this just all the time. Of course, I had to talk about the Big Daddy Trash too. This plugin is just awesome. Aside from the epic presets that it's just got so many capabilities with multi-band, having convolution reverbs and two filters and a built-in compressor and delay. It's just a beast of a plugin, so if you don't have it, you gotta have it. I wouldn't be making bass music if I didn't have Saturn. Come on, like this is like a staple for a lot of the bass guys. I don't know, it's just an awesome plugin as well. Next up, delay group. I'm just gonna put one delay in this group because Echo Boy is literally my go-to plugin. If I had to choose a plugin to live with and get married to, I think it would be Echo Boy. Yeah, I don't know. I love it. I love it. You hear me? I love it. Next up, reverbs. Everybody knows Valhalla Room. It's a nice hall reverb. I don't have to say anything else about it. Arts Acoustic Reverb has got great rooms, great types or whatever you want to call them. It's got a lot of capabilities. I really like the dry, wet level knobs, and you can automate them to make really cool effects. Yeah, it's just a really versatile reverb plugin. I really like it a lot. Last but not least, if you have the money to buy this, this thing's a beast. It's a convolution reverb. You should use it. In this group, I just called audio manipulation just because it does a lot of different things. So let's just dive into it. First up, I got Manipulator by Infected Mushroom. It's got a great stereo feature. I don't know, it's just an awesome plugin. Again, I keep saying awesome plugin, but you know, I just use this all the time. So it's awesome for vocals. It's great for bass design. It has sick presets. If you're into psytrance, it's sweet, you know, whatever. Moving on. FL Vocodex is just a vocoder in FL. I use this a lot for bass design, and using vocoders is quite versatile and there's a lot of possibilities. So I'd suggest you dig into that a bit. And lastly, I want to talk about Volume Shaper. This is a sweet plugin. There's a lot of possibilities with this. Let's say you're shaping a kick, you can use it to cut out the highs towards the end of the tail to give it more of like a closing sound without having to split it into parallel. So yeah, it's sweet. It's a sweet though. Anyway, I hope that was helpful. Like I said, I probably forgot some goldies, but oh well. These are just the plugins we use, so they might not work for you, or you don't want to work with them, or whatever. I feel like sometimes it's good to get a perspective of what other people in the industry are using as well. And when you find other producers who use the same plugins, it feels kind of nice. You're like, oh yeah, in group, we're friends. And I want to be friends with you, so get these plugins and we can be friends. Hope that helped. Peace.